This is the final voyage of the USS Nassau as it heads to the Steel Coast Scrapyard in Brownsville, Texas. When active, she was capable of transporting more than 3,000 United States Navy and United States Marine Corps personnel. Ingalls Shipbuilding in Pascagoula, Mississippi, laid the ship's keel on August 13, 1973. She was commissioned on July 8, 1979. She was decommissioned on March 31, 2011. The Nassau had 1,400 compartments, 9 elevators, and 2 horizontal conveyors. She also had 2 boilers, the largest ever manufactured for the United States Navy. They could generate 4,000 tons of steam per hour and develop 140,000 horsepower. Nassau's electrical power subsystem provided 14 megawatts of electrical power. She had air conditioning equipment rated at a total of 1,500 tons and could ballast 12,000 tons of seawater for trimming the ship to receive a discharge landing craft in the well deck. She was constructed with more than 20,000 tons of steel, 3,000 tons of aluminum, 400 miles of cable, and 80 miles of pipe. She had a 900 horsepower bow thruster for lateral movement at low speeds that could move the bow with 20,000 pounds of force, equivalent to half the pulling power of a diesel railroad locomotive. She was fitted with a 300-bed hospital, 4 medical and 3 dental operating rooms. Her cargo areas were capable of holding tanks, trucks, artillery, and large warfare supply needs. USS Nassau was commissioned at Pascagoula, Mississippi on July 28, 1979. In October, she deployed to reinforce Guantanamo Base and earned the Navy Meritorious Unit Commendation just 70 days after commissioning. In April 1981, the ship was deployed to the Mediterranean to meet U.S. commitment to have 2 carriers there. She operated for 10 consecutive weeks as an aircraft carrier reinforcing 6th Fleet carrier USS Saratoga. Marine Attack Squadrons 231 and 542 formed Marine Air Group 32, equipped with AV-8A planes. It was the first time U.S. Navy operated an amphibious ship as a Harrier carrier. Nassau was deployed to Beirut with the 24th Marine Amphibious Unit in February 1984, less than 4 months after the Beirut Erics bombing. In support of Operations Desert Storm, NASA deployed to the Middle East for over 8 months on only 8 days' notice. On leaving the United States, NASA became the flagship for Commander Amphibious Task Force and the 4th MEB's commanding general. In the last week of the war, she was employed as a Harrier carrier, tasked with operating primarily as a Stovall attack carrier for Marine AV-8B Harrier 2 fighters. NASA participated in several more operations throughout the 1990s, including Operations Uphold Democracy, Deny Flight, Allied Force, and Noble Anvil. These operations were in support of U.S. foreign policy objectives. She also participated in numerous Navy and joint exercises that took her to numerous locations in the Atlantic, Mediterranean, and Adriatic regions, including Haiti, Spain, Morocco, Italy, France, Greece, Israel, Albania, Zaire, and Kosovo. NASA received her first Battle Effectiveness E Award in November 1983 and a second in 2007. These awards are presented annually to ships that demonstrate the highest state of combat readiness in their group and their ability to execute their wartime tasks. She deployed in February 2008 as the flagship of the Nassau Expeditionary Strike Group in support of maritime security operations and theater security cooperation efforts in the Navy's 5th and 6th Fleet areas of responsibility. In addition to her primary role as a marine transport, Nassau has served as a flagship, a logistics hub for incoming and outgoing mail, cargo, and other supplies, combat search and rescue, and tactical recovery and rescue of downed aircraft and personnel. In July 2008, she had returned from deployment and was undergoing maintenance. At 4:30 p.m. Central Time on Thursday, 18th of September 2008, KHOU News 11 in Houston, Texas announced that Nassau was coming to the aid of Galveston Island following the landfall of Hurricane Ike. Nassau anchored 7 miles offshore, and troops deployed to the island with heavy machinery to aid with the cleanup of the devastation caused by the hurricane. In January 2010, NASA left her Virginia port carrying the 24th Marine Expeditionary Unit on a routine deployment of approximately 7 months. The 24th MEU, based at Camp Lejeune, North Carolina, consisted of ground combat element, battalion landing team, an aviation combat element, a logistics combat element, and a command element. NASA accompanied the USS Mesa Verde and USS Ashland, comprised the NASA Amphibious Ready Group, which supported supported maritime security operations and more in the 5th and 6th Fleet areas. The 5th Fleet covers the Persian Gulf, the Red Sea, the Gulf of Oman, and parts of the Indian Ocean. The 6th Fleet encompasses the Mediterranean Sea. Nassau was diverted to Haiti on January 21, 2010 to assist with the international humanitarian aid effort following the earthquake. After completing its humanitarian efforts in Haiti, Nassau continued on its mission to the Middle East, eventually tying the all-time Navy record of 159 consecutive days out at sea without a port call. Nassau was decommissioned in Norfolk, Virginia on March 31, 2011. She was moored in Beaumont, Texas with the MARAD National Defense Reserve Fleet ships. The Nassau departed Beaumont, Texas on her final voyage on April 23, 2021. She arrived in Brownsville April 30, 2021. Ha 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 ha